So go ahead and taste it. This is Pink Street cream. You guys are going to learn how to make this.
I make it differently than the Love and Sugar Surprise.
When I cool my pastry cream, I always pour it out into a sheet tray. Oftentimes it'll say put it into an ice bath. I never put mine in an ice bath. I always pour it out onto a sheet tray with plastic wrap. Remember this.
Yeah.
Because it immediately stops the cooking and it pulls the plastic over it. Excuse me. This is good to like make fresh fruit tarts with. And it's also good to fill eclairs. Yeah, and this also you can make what's called a diplomat, which is pastry cream with some gelatin, and then you fold in some heavy whipped cream, and it's really, really beautiful. It's nice and milky and pretty. My recipe does not have any egg whites in it. It's all egg yolk, because egg yolk is all what?
Fat.
Fat is potato, right?
Yeah.
So as soon as you make pastry cream, you cover it up like this so it doesn't get the skin as the pudding. Right? And you just put it in the refrigerator and let it cool. You cannot freeze pastry cream.
Remember this.
You cannot freeze pastry cream or any sort of pie filling that uses cornstarch. Cornstarch is activated by
heat.
It swells the starch, and the starch helps absorb the water, which makes it thicken, right? Think about your sauces and everything that you make, your slurries and stuff, or savory. Same thing here. So if you freeze it, it deconstructs the cornstarch, and all the water will come pouring out of this cream that you need. You can't reheat it because your eggs are already cooked in nice low temperature. So if you're gonna make pastry cream, you're gonna make it, you're gonna use it within 3 days. Okay, it's a labor of love. Did you guys taste it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Very good.
All right, back to work.
Which one was the green?